On YouTube, you can find ton of video about these so-called solenoid motors. They look very impressive, but their efficiency is terrible. Still, they usually get a lot of use, so I decided to take it further and build a huge version of my own. My goal was to make something strong enough to move a vehicle and hopefully reach a few million views, so maybe I could become a YouTube star. That meant I needed a last 100 to 200 watt of power. As a base, I planned a square tube frame so I could use the solenoid motor either in the bicycle or in the scooter. The first step was to make the heart of the solenoid motor. A big and powerful electromagnet, which would act as the cylinder of the motor. This electromagnet pushes a steel rod, which works as the piston. To build the huge coil, I use my homemade lathe to produce plastic discs that fit on the ends of the 32mm PVC pipe. This pipe became the coil base, and the inside in the piston can move. Thanks to the disc, I could wind the copper wire in stressed layers. I used 1mm enamel coated copper wire. I needed exactly 1000 meters of wire, which gave me about 7150 turns. The winding took me a whole day, and the coil ended up weighing more than 5 kilograms. I really hope this video pay back at least the cost of the copper wire, because so far YouTube has only cost me money. So please leave a comment and a like, so that millions can see this video. For the bike drive, I went with the simplest method, friction drive. A small wheel on the motor shaft presses against the rear wheel of the bicycle. In the scooter version, the motor shaft itself is the rear wheel axle. To make the shaft, I used an 18mm threaded rod because it's easy to mount and remove. To keep it perfectly centered, I machined some on M18 nuts into adapters that fit the 20mm bearings. At first, I wanted to build a front wheel drive with a belt system. But for the YouTube video and for a better thumbnail, I decided to make it a rear wheel drive instead. After all, the success of the video comes first. If you'd like to support my work, make sure to subscribe, drop a random comment, like how many tools you have, and hit the like button, because the algorithm really loves that. And if this video reaches 1 million views, I show you the trickiest parts of the solenoid motors that almost nobody notices. Controlling the coil was not an easy task. In smaller YouTube projects, people usually use switches or contacts to turn the coil on and off. But here the coil has serious power and the current is too high to mechanical switches. So I decided to use an inductive sensor. First, I machined a half circle piece of aluminium and mounted into the end of the shaft. That's what the sensor watches. At first, my plan was to use a simple relay to switch the current, but the relay burned out quickly. So I connected the coil through the cheap PWM module and used the relay to control the PWM input. This way I could also adjust the power and speed with a knob. Then I started testing. What you don't see in the video is that these were not the first test at all. The first one were terrible. It was very hard to get the motor working. It took almost a full day of adjusting before I found the right settings. The shaft alone couldn't turn over from the piston's momentum, so I had to mount a lathe chuck to act as a flywheel. The efficiency was horrible. After I removed the 14kg chuck, the bicycle on wheel worked much better as a flywheel. I think the output power was not even 40 watts. According to ChatGPT, 40 watts is just barely enough to move a bicycle, so I decided to give it a try. The motor became more responsive, the speed increased, and it actually looked like a working project. But in the main test, 40 watts still turned out to be very weak. The bike moved from point A to point B, but the result was not very convincing. I had no other choice but raise the voltage. I replaced the 12-volt lead-acid batteries with a 20-volt Parkside tool batteries. I even talked about connecting two in series for 40 volts, but my controllers couldn't handle that. I also solved some on timing problems, so the coil would fire at the exact right moment and for the right amount of time. Now the results were visible even with the motor clamped in a vise. In some on position, it could spin even without a flywheel. Mounted on the bicycle, the power was actually scary. It could reach about 10 km per hour, and even a small hill didn't stop it. Also, for a better clickbait thumbnail, I gave it a nice baby blue paint job. But that's still not all. After the bicycle test worked so well, I decided to build a scooter version too. And that one also worked great. So everything was ready for an awesome YouTube video. If I reach 100k subscribers this year, I will win a bet I made with one of my friends. The prize is 2004 Opel Astra with 500,000 km on it, which burn 2 deciliter of engine oil every 100 km. So if you enjoy my content, please subscribe and check out my creepy videos too. Because I actually quit my job to become a full-time YouTuber. My goal is to cover my living cost with YouTube, which means about $6,000 a year or roughly 5 million views. Thanks for watching. Wish me a luck.